Welcome friends, let us continue to study about the poems on my YouTube channel. Kindly like, share and subscribe my YouTube channel. In today's lecture, we are going to study about the construction and working of positive displacement pump, but rotary type pump. And particularly, we are going to study about the gear pump, vane pump and the screw pump. Gear pump. So now this is the sketch of the gear pump, and the right hand side you can see the animation of the gear pump. So ultimately it has the two gears on which teeth are engraved, and two gears are interconnected and they are located inside a casing, and when they rotate due to the electric motor, the liquid is transferred from one place to another place. You can see the another animation for the gear pump which works or which rotates at very high speed. This is the another animation which you can see the flow of liquid from suction to the discharge. You can see the another animation where the fluid or the flow of liquid, initially it is entered through the inlet, then it is filled up between the gear tooth, and then it moves from left hand side to right hand side, that is up to the exit or the fluid outlet. Construction. It contains two interconnected gears. These gears are placed in casing, so it is placed in a casing. One gear is connected to electric motor. This gear is known as a driving gear. And another gear is known as the driven gear. So one gear is connected to the electric motor, and this the gear which is connected to the electric motor, that is known as the driving gear, and another gear is known as the driven gear. As the electric motor rotates, the driving gear rotates, which in turn rotates the driven gear. So as the electric motor rotates, gear number one rotates, and due to that the another gear also rotates in opposite direction. At one side there is a suction and another side there is a discharge. You can see the suction is at the inlet and the right hand at the left, and the outlet or the discharge is at the right hand side. Working. As the electric motor rotates, driving gear rotates, which in turn rotates the driven gear. So as the first gear rotates, the second gear also rotates. Now both the gear rotate in opposite direction. Now when intermeshed teeth of both the gear disengage, so whenever the during the rotation, when the teeth at this portion disengage, the partial vacuum is created inside the gear pump, and thus liquid enters through the section. So whenever the gear disengage at this location, some very minor partial vacuum is generated, and due to that water is filled up inside this section. Then the liquid is enclosed, entrapped between two teeth of a gear and casing. So whatever the liquid has entered, now that liquid is, you can see here, it is filled between two teeth, and now it has to move from your left hand side to right hand side along with the teeth. Now the enclosed liquid has to move along with the gears, and thus liquid is pumped to the discharge section. Application. Gear pumps are commonly used for pumping high viscosity fluids. It means the fluid which having the high viscosity, for that the gear pumps are being utilized, such as oil, paints, resins or foodstuffs. They are preferred in any application where accurate dosing or high pressure output is required. So whenever we require the accurate high pressure, and if you want to use the high viscosity fluid, then gear pump is utilized. The left hand side figure is the external gear pump, and right hand side figure or the animation shows us the internal gear pump, in which the one of the gear having the internal teeth. This is the another animation for the internal gear pump on the right hand side and the external gear pump on the left hand side. vane pump. So now this is the vane pump. You can see here, it has a rotor, circular rotor. And on the circular rotor, here, 6 grooves are there. On the rotor, 6 holes are there, or you can say 6 grooves are there. But in the 6 holes or 6 grooves, the vanes are connected or vanes are attached with the help of the spring. So whatever the black is there, it is nothing but the spring. And this portion is known as the vane. So vanes are connected or inserted into the grooves of the rotor. So whenever the rotor rotates, you can see here, right? If there is no gap, then what will happen? With the help of the spring, the vane will go inside the rotor. And if there is a gap, the vane will come out. So that is nothing but the working of the vane in a vane pump. Let us see by animation. You can see here. So here 6 vanes are there, or ultimately 6 grooves are there in which 6 vanes are located. So when the rotor or white color rotor rotates, you can see here, the space is more here. So the vane will come out. But when the rotor moves up, the gap between the vane and the outer body is not there. And due to that, vane will go inside. And it will compress the spring, black color spring. And the green color shows the liquid, the movement of the liquid from inlet to the outlet. This is another animation where the liquid moves from your left hand side to right hand side. Construction. It contains a rotor mounted on a shaft of the electric motor. So this is the rotor, and that rotor is mounted on a shaft of electric motor. So as the electric motor rotates, this rotor will also rotate. On the periphery of rotor, grooves are prepared or holes are there. Sliding vanes are arranged in each groove with the spring. Thus, when we press the sliding vane, it moves inside the groove and it comes out when we release the pressure on it. The rotor is placed inside the casing eccentricity. So this is the outer casing. The rotor with the vanes are connected to the casing, but not at the same center of the casing, but at the another center, and due to that, there is a variable gap between the casing and the rotor. Due to this arrangement, there is a non-uniform gap between the rotor and casing. If we have connected the rotor at the same center of the casing, there may be the uniform gap between the casing and rotor. But here, we are not connecting the rotor at the same center of the casing, and due to that, there is a variable gap between the casing and the rotor. Sliding vanes are always in contact with the casing. At one side there is a suction and another side there is a discharge. So this is a suction and this is a discharge. Working. As the electric motor rotates, rotor also rotates and fluid enters the pump. Fluid is entrapped between two vanes and casing. So you can see, whenever the fluid enters, it is entrapped between two vanes and a casing. Thus, entrapped fluid has to rotate along with the rotor from suction to the discharge section. And when fluid moves from the suction to the discharge section, gap between the rotor and casing also decreases. So here, the gap is more, but when it moves from inlet to outlet, gap is reduced. And thus, fluid is compressed. The compressed fluid comes out from the discharge section. Application. Vane pumps are commonly used as a high pressure hydraulic pump. So it is mainly utilized in the high pressure hydraulic pumps. It is mainly utilized in automobiles, including supercharging, power steering, air conditioning, and automatic transmission pumps. And pump for the mid-range pressure. If it is a medium range pressure pump, then it is utilized as a carbonator for fountain, soft drink dispensers, and espresso coffee machines. Next pump we are going to study is the screw pump. So it contains the two screws interconnected with each other. And with the one screw, the electric motor is connected. So as the one screw rotates, another screw also rotates. So at one end, there is an inlet, and another end, there is an outlet. You can see it by animation also here. So this is screw number 1, which is connected to electric motor. So as the electric motor rotates, this screw will rotate. The liquid or the fluid will enter, and it will be placed inside the, between two screw sets. And due to that, it will move from inlet to outlet, and from outlet, it will come out. It contains two interconnected screws. These screws are placed inside a casing. One screw is connected to electric motor. This screw is known as the driving screw, and another screw is known as the driven screw. As the electric motor rotates, driving screw rotates, which in turn rotates the driven screw. At one end there is a suction and another end there is a discharge. As the electric motor rotates, driving screw rotates, which in turn rotates the driven screw, and fluid enters the pump. Then the liquid is enclosed, entrapped between the passage of both screws, that is the screw sets, and then moves from the suction through the discharge. This is left hand side, you can see the twin screw pump. Here it is a three screw pump because there are three screws in the arrangement application. Three spindle screw pumps are mainly utilized for transport of viscous fluids with lubricating properties. So if you want to transport or the increase the pressure of viscous fluid, then we can use the screw pumps, or particularly the three screw pumps. They are suited for variety of applications such as fuel injections, oil burners, boosting, hydraulic, fuel, lubrication, circulating, feed, and so on. Kindly ask your queries in the comment box of the video. Kindly like, share, and subscribe my YouTube channel. Thank you.